Globally, we've seen how nations strive to keep up with the digital world. Hong Kong has recently launched its humanoid robot named Sophia.
Hello, everyone. It's been a really exciting year for me.
In the United States, cars are already driving on their own. In the Philippines, technological innovations are being developed by local scientists and are being adopted by Philippine industries. This is the fourth industrial revolution, an era of advanced technological breakthroughs. The fourth industrial revolution is reshaping the way people live, work, and communicate. From purchasing goods online, even with smart glasses, to boosting productivity of businesses, discovering new ways to provide better healthcare with 3D printed organs, to enhancing food security using robots and drones for precise spraying of herbicides. While the rise of this revolution provides new jobs and business opportunities, some jobs may be displaced. The International Labor Organization predicts that about half of jobs in five Southeast Asian countries are at high risk of being affected by automation. Jobs that are at risk are those that involve much repetition and less creativity. To prepare us for the risk of job losses and a likely rise in inequality, we must all understand the changing landscape and do our share in making our current and future workforce flexible for the emerging job market. We must also provide protection for those who may not be capable to adjust to changes. The government should be able to strengthen social protection, provide flexible social safety nets, and promote labor policies that will reduce workers' exposure to risks. It should likewise introduce a robust program on emerging technologies, such as putting more investment in research and development, increasing the pool of scientists and engineers, and providing better incentives for innovation. Given the changing technological landscape, the government also needs to rethink its regulatory framework. It should make it more open, flexible, and less burdensome for new businesses and investments. Meanwhile, the business sector should assist its workers adapt to the demands of modern technologies through retraining, on-the-job training, and mentoring and coaching programs. Both the government and the private sector should work together to create an environment that fosters and embraces innovation. The entire educational system also has an important role to play by mainstreaming digital skills in basic education, developing and promoting courses in science, technology, and mathematics, and incorporating both cognitive and non-cognitive skills development in their curriculum.
The government, business sector, schools, and workers have a stake in harnessing the fourth industrial revolution. Given that this revolution demands attention, we made it the central theme of this year's Development Policy Research Month, or DPRM. Every September, the Philippine Institute for Development Studies leads the entire nation in celebrating the DPRM to emphasize the importance of policy research in the formulation of appropriate policy interventions to emerging and current development concerns. Its main and culminating activity is the annual Public Policy Conference, or APPC, which convenes and engages policy analysts, social scientists, and representatives from government and the private sector in a rational and evidence-based discussion of issues, opportunities, and policy options. Through this year's APPC, which carries the theme Harnessing the Fourth Industrial Revolution, Creating Our Future Today, we aim to encourage everyone to be proactive in preparing for and adapting to the changes that come along with today's digital transformations. The Fourth Industrial Revolution is here. Let us use it to our advantage.